Hi, I'm Jake, the DIY guy. Today I'm going to walk you through the JASCO in-wall add-on switch quick start guide. In this quick start guide, we'll review the installation and the setup of a three-way switch. Now keep in mind, in order to use this, you're going to need to pair it with a GE or JASCO smart dimmer or switch. For our installation, we're going to be using an in-wall smart switch as the primary. Now first things first, let's familiarize ourselves with the parts of the switches. This gold terminal is your traveler terminal, where you attach your traveler line, which is usually indicated by a red outer covering on your wire. The silver one is your neutral terminal, where your neutral line is hooked in, normally indicated by a white covering on your wire. And this green terminal is your ground, which is usually a bare copper wire. The two black terminals are your load and your line terminals. The line terminal is your hot wire that connects your switch to the power. The load wire connects your switch to the lighting. The silver terminal is for your neutral. That's where your neutral lines will be hooked in. That's normally a bundle of white wires in the back of your switch box. And the green terminal is for your ground wire, which is commonly bare copper wire in the switch location. Now the gold terminal covered with a piece of insulation tape, that is the traveler terminal. This is where you would attach the traveler wire for use with the GE add-on switch for three or four-way control of your lighting. The first step to installing your switch is to shut the power to the circuit off at the circuit box or the fuse box. Now we're going to remove the wall plates from both switches. When removing the switch, make sure you don't dislodge any wires as you pull it out. Now I'm going to show you how to identify which is the primary or line switch and which is the load or add-on switch. Once these switches have been removed from the boxes, identify the black screw on each switch. Because both switches are identical, you have to know which switch is connected to the breaker box and which switch is connected to the light fixture. Now you have to turn the power back on. Now you must be very careful because all of the electrical connections are exposed. First, I'm going to test the bottom switch. And make sure you test the black screw. Using your multimeter, I'm getting some power on this, so this is my primary switch. Just to verify, testing my common, I have no power there, so this is my add-on or load switch. Now turn the power off. The next step is to identify which switch is the line switch. Label the black wire connected to the black terminal line. Now identify which switch is connected to the light fixture. Label the black wire connected to the black terminal load. The remaining two wires on each switch are the travelers. Once we've labeled both common wires on the primary and the add-on switch, remove all of the wires from the switch. Now we're going to locate the neutral wires. They will be a bundle of white wires in the back of the box, connected by a wire nut. Find the bundle, pull it out, and remove the wire nut. Then use a length of wire and add it to that bundle in the wire nut. Then place the bundle back into the box. Now we're ready to install our switch. Take the white wire and insert it into the neutral terminal. Now insert the wire marked line into the line terminal. Make sure you push all of the bare wire into the back of the device. Now install the bare ground wire into the green ground terminal. At this point, you should have two wires left unconnected. These are your traveler wires. Choose one of them, it doesn't matter which, and install it into the load terminal. But note which color you use, because we'll need to know this when we install the add-on switch. The last remaining wire, the red one, is the traveler wire. Install that behind the white tape, but remove the white tape first. Once the primary device is connected, we can turn our attention to the add-on device. Look into the back of the box for the white wires bundled together under a wire nut. Remove that wire nut. Now take a piece of wire and add that to the wire nut. Take the neutral wire and add it to the neutral terminal. Attach the bare ground wire to the green ground terminal. Now we have three wires left unconnected, the wire marked load and two traveler wires. Take the wire marked load and the traveler wire that matches the same color traveler wire that we connected to the load terminal earlier. In this case, it's black. Connect those two wires using a wire nut. These two wires will not connect to any terminals on the switch. Now take the remaining wire, the red one in this case, and insert it into the traveler terminal. Now that both switches are wired, you can push them into the box. Be careful not to pinch any of the wires. Now we're ready to put the wall plates on. At this point, you can turn the power on at the circuit breaker, and we can test the system. You should now have complete control to turn your lights on and off using both the primary and the add-on switch. It's important to note that your add-on will function exactly as your primary. So if your primary is a dimmer, your add-on will also have dimming control. Live life smart with Z-Wave lighting controls from JASCO.